Morning, everyone. Very thanda good morning. Good morning, everyone. That's more like it. So, since our release, generally before saying something, we tend to ask questions. So, my first question for today would be, how many of you are 18 years and above? Raise your hands. 18 years and above? Nobody, right? 16 years and above? Few of you. Very few of you. Do you know what is the legal age of driving?
18 years.
Yes, right? 18 years and above. After 18 years and so, after you are 18 years old, you get the driving license. Very good, smart kids. You all know everything already. So why did I ask this question? Because my next question is going to be, how have you reached the school? All of you over there, how have you reached the school? I know you kids have reached by cycling. But those kids, right at the back, even if you guys don't tell the truth, these kids will tell you the truth. So yes, I know that you have reached this to your school. Quite a lot of you have reached school on your own bikes. So is this right or wrong? See, even the kids know that it is wrong. You are the bigger, smarter kids. You know that it is wrong. But still, you tend to do it. Why do we tend to do it? Why are we doing it? When we know it is wrong, why are we doing it? Because we think that accidents won't happen to us, it will happen to somebody else. It is always somebody else till it happens to us. You realize this? It is always somebody else till it happens to us. Statistically in India, every year we lose more than 1 lakh people on the road. Which means every day we lose close to 400 people on the road. Which means by the time I am here, I reach somewhere close to 8 o'clock. It's almost around 8:35. We have already lost 15 people on the road by this time. 15 people have left this earth and gone to someplace else in the 35 minutes that I have been here. Do you think it's a justifiable thing to happen? Losing our people on the road? What should we be doing? We should be caring for lives, right? We should be more considerate about lives. We should try and save lives, right? How can we do that? How can we save lives? By obeying few traffic rules. What are those few rules? Very good! Oh my God, I'm so happy, so proud. I'm really happy. It looks like the teachers have taught you really well. See? On what side of the road should you be driving?
From what side should we be overtaking?
Left side.
Overtaking from the? Very good. So you all know all the rules. So
honestly raise your hands. How
limits. So, for the ones whose parents are not wearing helmets, what do you go back and tell your parents today? Wear helmets, otherwise I will not go to school. Tell them. Wear helmet, otherwise I will not go to school. You have to threaten them. They are not listening to anybody. But I am sure they will listen to you. So what do you go back and tell? Also, have you seen, these days there are these small helmets, small mini helmets. For this I need to go to that side of the hall. So how many of you kids own a mini helmet? Small helmet? How many have a small helmet? Are you wearing a small helmet? For all the kids who do not have mini helmets, let me tell you a little bit of the rule, little bit part of the rule. So in a two-wheeler, generally only two people can sit. But if the parents have a small kid, obviously they will not leave the kid at home and go. They will take the kid. So three people are allowed in that case. In a two-wheeler, when can three people sit? When there is a child. What age is the child allowed? Till what age is the child allowed to sit? Till 12 years. Okay. Till 12 years, a father and a mother can take their child along with them and go. But in that case, how many people should be wearing the helmet?
Three.
All three should be wearing the helmet. Right? Which means you people should be wearing a mini helmet. Okay? So you go back today. Go back and ask your parents to buy each one of you one mini helmet. You will do that, right? One kid over here. Mini helmet. Demand for a mini helmet. Why should you be demanding for a mini helmet? Safety. Why do we need a helmet? So when your father takes you out to market and he wears a helmet, does he not care about your head? So let's say, for example, God forbid this should not happen. Let's say somebody, you are traveling with your father on a motorcycle, and God forbid one accident happens. Your father is wearing a helmet. His head is safe. What about you? What about you? So that is why you should also be wearing a helmet. Right? So you guys need to go back today and demand your parents to bring you one mini helmet. So the concept is, the basic rule is, everyone in your family should have their own personal helmet. Whenever they move out of the house, they should have their own helmet. Father is sitting, mother is sitting in the back. Mother should wear. Both people on the two-wheeler should be wearing their own helmet. Because when there's an accident, will the road say that this person was driving the motorcycle, that's why I will hit this person? This person was sitting behind, let me not hit this person. Will the road distinguish? Will the other vehicle be dashing with this vehicle? Will it distinguish that this person was sitting behind? Let me not hit this person. That won't happen, right? So simple logic. If there is an accident, both will be affected. So who will be wearing the helmet? If three people sitting there? So that That is the rule also. If you do not wear a helmet, unnecessarily we will have to fine you. Do you want me to fine you? Even I don't want to fine you. I don't want the money. What will I do with the money? I can't even take it home. I don't want your money. But what do I want? When you are on the road, why do they say that before 18 years of age you should not be driving? Why? Because before 18, what happens is our brains are not developed that way. We do think that we are very smart. I know. I have been there. I know. I have been there already. We do think that ये बड़े लोग क्या बोल रहे हैं हम लोग तो बिल्कुल समझ रहे हैं. I know. I do agree. But you know what? When you pass that age and when you reach here, you do realize that I was so stupid to think like that. That person who was telling me to obey the rules was actually doing it for my benefit. So today you may not realize this, but I hope it's not late for you to realize this. So it is my earnest request. Please, till you do not get a valid driving license, please do not drive. You are putting your own lives at risk. You are putting other people who are using the roads at risk. There are many cases in which we have seen because of underage driving, parents have lost their only son. Last week I attended one memorial service in which there was one grieving mother who has started a road safety unit for saving other kids. Why did she start it? Because her underage son died in a road accident. You know what had happened? The vehicle was being driven by somebody who was under 18 years of age. First mistake. Only the driver was wearing a helmet, luckily. Nobody else in the vehicle was wearing a helmet. Second mistake. They were using a speed bike. Third mistake. There were, how many people were sitting in the bike? Three people. Fourth mistake. How were they driving? In a zigzag pattern and over speeding. They tried to negotiate between one bus and a truck in between that. Fifth mistake. How many more mistakes did they need to do? Do you know what happened? Out of those three kids, two of them died on the spot. On the spot. The third person was in ICU for 1 week. The third person who was sitting, somehow he was flung away from the truck. And he was in ICU for entire 1 week. Now he cannot walk. He's lost his legs. What is the utility of having such a life? This is such a sad story. Don't you think this is a sad story? Do you agree with me it is a sad story? Do you think it cannot happen to you? Do you think it is impossible to happen to you? It can happen to anybody, right? It's an accident. An accident can happen to anybody. An accident will not give an invitation before coming. An accident will not knock at your doors before coming. An accident can happen absolutely anytime. What we can do to prevent such accidents? We can be a bit careful. We can simply follow some rules. Do you understand? Can you even imagine the plight of that mother when she saw the lifeless body of her son? Can you imagine the plight? Do you want your parents to go through that same pain ever? Every year in India, 12 lakh people lose their hands or legs, or their spinal cord is fractured, or they become disabled because of road accidents. 12 lakh. 1 lakh lose their lives, but 12 lakh lose one of their limbs. So what? What are we doing? What are we really doing? Why are we not concerned about this thing? Why do we take it so lightly? Driving a vehicle on the road is a skilled activity. It is as skilled as driving an aeroplane in the air. It is even more difficult, I would say. These days, aeroplanes are on autopilot mode. You don't even need to drive an aeroplane. But when you drive a two-wheeler, you have to be very, very, very cautious on the road. You have to be constantly attentive. You may not be at fault, but because of somebody else's fault, you may land in trouble. You may be driving at a speed of, let's say, 40 km per hour. Let's say somebody from the wrong side comes and dashes onto you. That is also possible. Sometimes you lose your life because of your own mistake. Sometimes you lose your life because of somebody else's mistake. So it is a highly skilled activity. We take it very casually, very lightly. And we say, what will happen if I do not obey a few rules? There are few people who argue with me that what will happen if I drive the vehicle on the wrong side? Kya ho jayega? अरे मैडम, मेरा घर ना यही पास में है, वहां से 200 मीटर कौन घूम के आएगा, यहाँ से 30 मीटर रॉन्ग साइड में लिया, आई विल गेट टू माई होम. इजंट इट? हैव यू सीन पीपल डूइंग दैट? राइट, नो? दे ऑलवेज टेंड टू टेक अ शॉर्टकट टू देयर होम इन द रॉन्ग साइड. डू यू थिंक इट इज द राइट थिंग टू डू? आई विल टेल यू वन मोर फैक्ट. यू I know I'm telling you, boring you with sad stories, but I have to tell you. Otherwise, what is happening? Okay? So, what is happening? So, we need to prevent accidents, so I need to tell you stories of accidents. I know you're small kids, you will be scared, and I should not be talking about death with you, but I also know that you're smart kids. And you can understand what I am saying. More than understand, I need you to really think about it and go back home and talk to your parents about it. So what happened, there was one gentleman who was on a motorcycle and he decided that he will not take a left turn and take a U-turn after 200 or 500 meters. Instead, he will take a right turn, go on the wrong side, and after 30 meters, he will find his own cut for the right side. Okay, this is what he decided one day. Very good. So he came onto the road. It was night, it was dark, it was a highway. So what vehicles go on a highway? Brilliant kids, man, brilliant kids. You know all the answers. So there was one big truck coming on the highway. This person decided that I will go on the wrong side. So when he came onto the road, he suddenly, this truck person, lucky for this two-wheeler, the truck person saw him. Like, oh my god, there is one motorcycle coming right onto my view. So what does he do? He immediately braked. But this truck person saw the person, this bike person saw the truck, he took a curve, he left. This truck braked. But what happened to the truck after that? The second truck could not brake because it was a sudden brake. Second truck did not realize that the truck in front of it has already braked. So what happened to the second truck? It crashed onto the first truck. What happened to the driver of the second truck? very much easier for that person if you have died. He was crushed between the two trucks. He was there for the next 2 hours, bleeding. We had to get those gas cutters, cut him out of the truck because all the iron pieces were crumpled. He was trapped inside the crumpled iron pieces. Then what did we do? Somehow we stopped his bleeding. We immediately sent him in our police vehicle to the nearest hospital. Somehow we managed to save him, but we had to cut both his legs. We had to cut both his legs. Because of whose fault? The bikers. Because that day, he decided that I will not take a 200 meters U-turn, instead I will take a 30 meters wrong turn. Because of the biker's fault, this driver who has been driving this truck for the last 10 years, who is the sole breadwinner of his family, who has 2 younger sisters who are yet to be married, who has 1 small kid who is 4 years old, this driver has lost his 2 legs, has lost the ability to drive ever again, and has lost the ability to support his family. So this biker did not damage only one person. This biker, who decided that day that I will take a wrong turn for 30 meters, damaged the entire family. The entire family of the driver is now helpless. They can do nothing about it. What amount of compensation can help these persons anymore? So these are a few. Can we do something to get these people in the shade? I think they are fainting because of the sun. Can we get them here maybe? So that they don't get in the sun. Why don't you keep me out of the shade over here? So that we can talk for a few more minutes.